And let's take a look, see what we get in the box of the Neewer Motorized Auto Dolly. We get some bits of information in here which tell you how to set up the dolly. We get the instruction manual for the Auto Dolly. We get ourselves a remote control where we can start using the dolly or we can pause it. We can change the direction that the dolly's going and we can increase and decrease the speed. We get ourselves a micro USB cable so we can charge the dolly up. We get ourselves an Allen key. And we get this circular piece of rubber which can go over one of the wheels if you have an issue with one of these rubbers. We get ourselves the mount that goes on top of the dolly so we can screw that in and then we can start screwing the camera on top. And we get the dolly itself. So we've got the little hole there so we can put the screw in there so we can start attaching cameras. And we do have three wheels on this dolly. We have the one on the front and we have the two on the back, which you can manipulate. And you've got little markers on the wheel as well, which tell you where you can position the wheel. So if you put those wheels out straight, you hit start on the side, your dolly will start moving left and right. If we start moving these wheels in, that will start moving the dolly in a circular motion. So depending on what you're trying to film, you can adjust these wheels accordingly. On the side, we've got the micro USB port, which allows us to charge the dolly up. We've got the off and on button. On the other side of the dolly, we've got the speed. And we've got the direction that we can change also. If we turn the dolly on, you've got this green light on the side. Now that tells you what your speed is. You can adjust that by tapping the speed button, or you can do it by using the remote. So if you press the plus and minus symbol, that will toggle between the three different speeds that you have on this dolly. You've also got the button on the right hand side, which allows you to change the direction that the dolly is going in. Once again, you've got that button on the remote control, so you can do it all from the remote if you want to. We've also got three screws on the bottom, which allows you to manipulate the dolly. You can adjust those using the Allen key that came with the device. The center screw allows you to move this forward and backwards, which basically means that if you've got yourself a heavy camera, for example, you can balance the weight a lot better by adjusting this screw, which should prevent your camera and the dolly from toppling over. And for the wheels, you can loosen or tighten them. And if you tighten them fully, they're going to be a little bit more difficult to actually manipulate. A huge benefit you have with this also is that you can actually pull these wheels off, which means that if you actually cause any damage to this wheel at all, you can actually replace the whole unit rather than replacing the whole dolly. Using the dolly on a flat surface produces amazing results. It moves very fluently. There's no noticeable juddering or jerking whilst footage is being filmed. This goes for both moving the dolly in a straight line or having it moving in a circular motion. Testing the dolly on carpet once again produces very good results. We were expecting it to really struggle when being used on carpet, but it exceeded our expectations. It glided across the carpet with no issues at all. This could be a different story if you use really thick carpet, but on the two different carpets that we tested it on, it worked fine and produced very smooth results. And moving on to concrete next, once again performs very well on flat concrete. But be aware, if you're going to use this on a cobble pavement, then you'll notice that you'll lose some of the smoothness. And to bear in mind as well that you begin to start damaging the rubbers on the wheels. It tends not to be too bad when you're filming sideways, but if you try and use a dolly in a circular motion, then it's a little less forgiving. The dolly travels at three different speeds. The slowest speed travels at 1.4 centimeters per second. The middle speed travels at 2.4 centimeters per second. And the fastest speed travels at 3 centimeters per second. And here's an example of what a video recording sounds like when using the dolly and using your internal microphone on the camera. Overall, the Neewer Motorized Dolly is a great gadget for anyone that's into creating videos and wants to produce different types of angles and movements in their shots. It's well built and it doesn't feel as though it's going to fall apart after a few uses. So if you're looking for a motorized dolly, then this is very affordable and produces great results. And our star rating on the Neewer Motorized Dolly will be 10 stars out of 10.